So let the student deal with aldehyde, ketones and acids. Now most of the questions depend upon the alpha hydride terms of the aldehyde and ketones. As you know, the reaction takes place aldol condensation and catalysis reactions. These are most important reactions of aldehyde and ketones. Now let us take some questions. Which of the following compounds are carbonyl compounds? Now all these compounds that are written there is RCOH, RCOH2, RCOH, RCOCl. All of them have got carbonyl group. CO group is all of them contain carbonyl group. But aldehyde and ketones explicitly endorse as carbonyl compounds. Now what is the difference between the aldehyde ketones and the remaining compounds there? RCOH, you find here RCOOH. The carbonyl group is there, but this would not resemble in the properties of the aldehyde. Why? Because this carbon is connected to oxygen carrying two pairs of electrons. And these play important role in the properties. Therefore, though all these compounds contain CO group, the group say is attached to OH. So this OH contains two pairs of electrons. NH2, a pair of electrons. And COCl, Cl has got three pairs of electrons. So these electrons which are present on the atom attached to the C play important role. Therefore, they have all the different properties. Hence, the carbonyl compounds are only RCHO or RCO. These are called as carbonyl compounds because the carbon is attached to carbon group CH3, which is not carrying any lone pairs of electrons. Therefore, the compounds which do not carry the lone pairs of electrons, they are called as usually carbonyl compounds. Okay? We'll go for the next question. Tautomerase is not exhibited by tautomerism. You have studied keto-elo tautomerism. For any compound which exhibiting the tautomerism must contain a carbonyl group, and this carbonyl group must be containing alpha hydrogen atoms. So such compounds will show the tautomerism. Here, this one undergo OH, double bond, CH, H. All you can write H. What happens is, this H slips over here, double bond slips over here. So this is called as tautomerism. So to exhibit the property of a tautomerism, there should be alpha hydrogen atoms. Now observe which of the compound is not having the alpha hydrogen atoms. B, it has got 5 alpha hydrogen atoms, CH3 this side, CH2 that side. Similarly, C, it has got alpha hydrogen atoms, alpha hydrogen next to CO. Similarly there, it has got alpha hydrogen. Here, no alpha hydrogen atoms. CO group, C, double bond C. Okay? Therefore, it is not carrying any alpha hydrogen atom. Therefore, it will not exhibit the isomerism. Okay, tautomerism is not exhibited. We go for the next question. Ozonolysis of C7H14 gives 2-methylpentene-3O identifies C7H14. C7H14, is it an alkene or alkene or alkyne? It is an alkene. C7H14. So it is containing a double bond in the compound. Alkene contains a double bond. It is heptene. It is 2-methyl. C7H14 is heptene. Now this on hydrolysis gives 2-methylpent-3O on ozonolysis. What happens on ozonolysis? When the ozonolysis is carried out, the carbon-carbon double bond breaks, O enters here, O enters here. Now, after ozonolysis, what you are getting right on the structure of methyl pent 3O? Pent 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2O, 2-methyl pent 2O. truly help this. So when this compound has to form, there should be double bond where the CO is formed. C double bond, that means we can write the compound in this way. CH3, CH2, C double bond O. Or we can write C double bond here. CH, CH3, CH3. Chain must contain the functional group and it must also contain the maximum branched carbon. Now here the maximum branched carbon is there because this carbon is not branching there. Therefore it is 1, 2, 3, 4. Is that clear? 1, 2, 3, 4. Not this. 1, 2, 3, 4. Allah. Yakala. Each chain of the branch is there. Better off. Therefore count 1, 2, 3, 4 and name the compound. What is the name of the compound? Tell me. 1, 2, 3. 3 methyl, 2 ethyl, butene, 1. And D. 3 ethyl, 1, 2, 3. This is ethyl. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. This is the third carbon. Second carbon ethyl group is there. Third carbon methyl group. Therefore, it is 2-ethyl. Name this compound. It is 2-ethyl, 3-methyl, butene 1. So please correct here. 2-ethyl, it is not 4, it must be 3. So make it 3. 4 is wrong written there. So it is not 4, it is 3. So 2-ethyl, 3-methyl, butene 1. Okay? This small mistake is it. If it's not 4, make it 3. Okay. We'll go for the next question. Compound X reacts with. What do we have this compound? Can you tell me? CH3, CH2, CO5O. Propionic anhydride. Propionic anhydride. When it is treated with propionic anhydride, in presence of sodium propionate. Now this is the Parkinson's reaction. Parkinson's reaction is aromatic aldehyde. Aromatic aldehyde react with acetaldehyde. Let us take simple example CH3CO5O. This is acetic anhydride. Okay? and the reaction takes place in presence of sodium salt of the same acid. What is acid? Acetic acid. Sodium acetate. CH3COOH. In this case, what happens is the alpha hydrogen atom of the acetic anhydride. This is the alpha hydrogen atom. This alpha hydrogen atom gets involved in the reaction. What happens here is ArCHO, this H enters to O. Alpha hydrogen atom enters to O. That means that we write here RCHO. Now alpha hydrogen atom shifts here. And this carbon shifts here. Therefore you get C. Who has got there? CH2COOH. This you are getting. And this compound will further lose a molecule of water. Beta hydroxyacetic it is. Therefore, you get ArCH. ArCH. Double bond CH2OH. So, in the Parkinson's reaction, you are getting alpha beta unsaturated acid. This is alpha, this is beta. Alpha, beta, and acid. This is called as Parkinson's reaction. The example given here is acetobenzaldehyde reacts with not acetic anhydride, it will react with the propionic anhydride. Write the propionic anhydride here. What is propionic anhydride? CH3, CH2, CO. What happens here? Tell me which hydrogens are involved here in the Parkinson's reaction? Alpha hydrogens are involved. This is alpha hydrogen. So this H goes over to this gets positive charge. This carbon which gets the negative charge comes here. Therefore you are getting ArCOOH. Then this carbon attaches to this carbon attaches to there, H here, COOH. So it is an alpha carbon which is involved in this reaction. Is that clear? And now this will lose a molecule of water. OH, yes. So you are getting CH3O, here is CH3O, CH. Double bond C, CH, double bond C. This carbon is going to CH3. So you are getting this alpha beta should also get this also Perkins reaction. What is there is? The compound obtained here is. What is the water? The compound X there. Compound X is methyl. This one. And so the benzaldehyde reacts. This will not react. Can you tell me whether this gets involved in the Parkinson's reaction? How about this? Will it turn into Parkinson's reaction? No. Why? This is not the aromatic aldehyde. This is not the aromatic aldehyde. Aromatic aldehyde is the one in which the CH2 is directly attached to CH3. Therefore, this must be benzaldehyde. Benzaldehyde, not B. You see, C is the reaction of the aromatic aldehyde. Parkinson's reaction is reaction of aromatic aldehyde. B is not aromatic aldehyde. It is beta phenyl ethanol. It is the aliphatic aldehyde, beta phenyl ethanol. And therefore, either A nor B nor T is only C which reacts here. Okay? Next one. Yes. Suitable reaction steps to carry out the following conversion. Now this unsaturated compound should be converted into aldehyde. Okay? What is happening here? How to get aldehyde? By oxidation of primary alcohol. Okay? observation of primary hypo. Primary hypo will undergo observation in your RDI. Right or not? Right. Now, from this you should get primary alcohol. How to get primary alcohol? CH2CH2H. Hydration. Hydration. If you carry out the acid hydration, you will get the Markovnikov product. Markovnikov product is what? A negative part of the carbon goes to the carbon containing acetyl amide. Therefore, you are getting CHOH and CH3. But here you want CH2OH. So to get the CH2OH, that means the anti-Markovnikov product is affected, and that is done by hydroboration and oxidation reaction. You have studied this under the properties of this liberation of the alkyl. Therefore, what is hydroboration and oxidation reaction? This one, BS3, that is tetrahydrofuran is a solvent. BS3 dissolved in that one, and that is treated with H2O in place of NOH. And then followed by PCC. PCC, what is PCC? Pyridium chlorochromate. This PCC will oxidize only alcohol group and not the unsaturation group present there. Now suppose you carry out the reaction, what do you get there? CH2, look here, CH2 double bond, CCS3, CH2, CH double bond CS2. This you have to first convert into alcohol without affecting this. Therefore, how do you do it? Boron hydride followed by oxidation in terms of H2O in alkali. This you know, hydroboration and oxidation reaction. What happens there? This will undergo reaction to give you CH2, double bond C, CS3, CH2, CH2, CH2OH. Now borohydride and the reaction does not take place here. This also contains double bond. Why the reaction does not take place here? The boron trihydride will not approach this because due to steric hindrance. Steric hindrance. There is a big CS group. Therefore, boron trihydride will not approach this. It is difficult to approach this. Therefore, it will approach to the least hindered double bond. That means the pH is acid. Therefore, this remains as it is, and this compound will give you the primary alcohol. Okay? Please remember, the boron trihydride reacts to the unhindered carbon-carbon double bond. This is hindered carbon-carbon double bond. Reaction does not take place. So you are getting this one. And this has to be converted into aldehyde by oxidation of primary alcohol. What is the best reagent you can use there? Oxidizing agent, pyridium chlorochromate. Pyridium chlorochromate is the best reagent to convert the primary alcohol group into the aldehyde without affecting the double bond. Without affecting the double bond. So this double bond remains intact and CH2O is oxidized to CH2O. If you use BS3 iodic acid, then iodic acid will convert oxidize this also. This is BF3 tetrahydrofuran and hydrofuran peroxide NOH. This reaction is like same. But this one is difficult. Here HiO2 is oxidizing agent. If you use this oxidizing agent, not only this, this also gets oxidized. This aldehyde converts and this aldehyde further converts to acid. Therefore, you are not getting the required compound there. Hence, best method of oxidizing the primary alcohol group is PCC. This is methyl chloride. This is solvent use. This is solvent use to dissolve PCC. That's all. Okay? So that is the reaction. Okay, any problem? Remember, once again I will repeat, double bond here, double bond here. Boron trihydride undergoes reaction with least hindered double bond. Alkyl group. This is. And therefore you are getting CH2, CH2. And this is further oxidation. CH2H has to be CH2. This remains intact. Okay, next one. You know some more mistake. This is CH2, CH3. This H has come there. This is CH2. This reference. Mistakes are reference. Which are following as a voice beginner? In voice beginner, what do you mean by voice beginner? Acidic property, acidity of the compound is described in the form of pK value. What is pK value? Minus log Ka. Minus log, what is Ka? Dissociation. So, pK value, if the pK value is less, it is more acidic. If the pK value is more, it will be less acidic. Now, pK value, lowest pK value, he wants to say which is the more acidic compound. So, that depends upon what is the acidity here. Acidity is for removal of proton. How is proton removed out? By removal of electrons. Look here. This is CO2. So this will have an electric charge. This carbon gets positive charge. This carbon positive charge may attack it from here. So it separates from the form of this. Okay? Same thing is there also. Same thing is here also. Same thing is here also. Out of these four, all these compounds are acidic in nature. Alpha hydrogen of the iron ketone are acidic. You have studied it. All the iron ketones, alpha hydrogen atoms are acidic in nature. All these compounds contain alpha hydrogen atoms. Now, look to see. Look to see. This CH2 group is flanked on either side by the CO group, strong electron withdrawing group. Is that clear? And this is alpha hydrogen. Now this CH2 group is called as active methylene groups. That is, these two hydrogen atoms can very easily replace or can easily remove out because of the CO group, electron withdrawing group. So due to this electron withdrawing group, the carbon carrying H2 will be more acidic. Why it is more acidic? Because on the either side, there are two carbonyl groups. And this CH2 group, which is present between the two negative groups, C11O, it will be acidic. And this CH2 is called as active methylene group. Active methylene group. So, this has more acidic property than anything else. Okay? This acidic property is due to the presence of carbonyl group electron withdrawing groups. This you know. Hydrogen ketones have got the alpha hydrogen atom acidic in nature. That is why it will undergo other condensation. Okay. Let's go for the next one. By the interaction between butanone plus this compound. Do you know what the name of the compound? Yes. Here you know the sp2 carbon atom is connected to phosphorus. First of all, phosphorus. I think once I told this compound is called as is classified under the classes what are called as elites. Probably you know it. Elites are the sp2 carbon atom. What are the electrons to change? sp2 carbon atom is connected to positively charged phosphorus, and such compounds are called as elites. Here it is triphenyl phosphorus. This is positive charge. And such compounds, say for example, CH2, CH2, CH3, CH. This is called as elite. These elites will react with ketones. They will react with ketone. Butanone is a ketone. Look here, the oxygen of the ketonic group, the oxygen of the ketonic group is replaced by what is elite there? The compound electron there is CH3, CH2, 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 CH. CH3, CH2, CH2, One more CH2 group is there, is it? One more CH2 group is there. CH2, CH, double bond, P, PH3. What is PH? Phenyl, type phenyl. Okay? So this is the allyl group there. This will react with the ketone. What is the ketone there? Butanone. So you write the CO group so that the CO group can be replaced by the alkene part of that compound. Say CH3, CH2, CH3. The reacting group was very close to each other so that you can understand the reaction completely. So what happens here? This will react with BH3, P linked to CH, CH2, CH2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, then CH2. In a catalyst, this oxygen is removed along with this octus type phenyl group. And therefore, you are getting PH3PO. Plus, this will join to this. Very simple, very simple. That is, the oxygen of the ketone group is removed along with the PPH3, and this carbon attaches to the remaining part of the alkene part. Okay? So, write it CH3, CH2, CCH3. Double bond CH, CH2, 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 CH2. Other name of the compound, don't tell me. CH3, CH2, CCH3. Then this connected to this carbon, double bond carbon. And then got 1, 2, 3, CH2. 3 times CH3. Other name of the compound, 1, 2, 3, 4. 5, 6, 7, 8. Octane. Which octane? 1, 2, 3. 3 methyl octane, 3. Second, B1. Okay? It is called as Wittig's reaction. It is called as Wittig's reaction. And this compound is called as allyl. And this is called Wittig's reaction. Simple. It is the method of preparation of the alkenes. Wittig's reaction is the method of preparation of alkene. Look here, this is how you get alkene. But it is 3 methyl octane 3. Okay? So that is called as Wittig's reaction. Excellent. Hexanone is treated with dilute solution of sodium hydroxide, followed by heat to give the product P, identify the product P. What type of reaction it is? Don't confuse this. Very, very simple reaction. Cyclohexanone. What is the function present there?
Ketone.
CO. Ketone. And cyclohexanone. This is cyclohexanone. Has it got alkyl atoms? Yes. Alkyl atoms here. Alkyl. Therefore, what happens here is, two molecules of cyclohexanone get involved in the formation of aldol condensation. What is aldol condensation? One of the hydrogen atoms present in the alpha position will go to the oxygen there. RO. Okay? OL. RN. RN or ketone? Ketone or RO. So since it has got the ketone group, it will form the ketone. Now what happens there? The alpha hydrogen atoms which are here or here will shift to the oxygen, making it this carbon attached to this. Therefore, what happens here is you can write it this way, which is very conductive of radium. Okay, and this will further undergo on heating, it will lose a molecule of water. Argon condition here at the top, you are getting beta hydroxy compound. It is a beta hydroxy compound because this is a ketone, alpha, this is alpha carbon atom, this is beta carbon atom, beta hydroxy ketone compound. Okay, so I have written the two ketones, and these three two ketones, the alpha hydrogen atom of one ketone, you can write the reaction in this way, which is better way of understanding. Both are named hexano. Both are hexano. Alpha hydrogen atom here, shift there. And only the hydrogen is there. So one hydrogen atom which is there in the alpha portion goes here, the remaining part will connect here. Therefore, you are getting this one. Followed or not followed. So you are getting the hydroxy compound. Beta hydroxy compound. This is beta hydroxy compound. The bond is established between this carbon and this carbon because the H is gone here. So this remains here. From this connection to OH. So this carbon remains here. So this carbon join each other to form the beta hydroxy compound. Okay? And this on further heating, this one and this one are separate of the form of water. So what we get there? This is the compound you are getting. Okay? That is beta hydroxy ketal is formed. Beta hydroxy ketone. Beta hydroxy are there, beta hydroxy ketone. So this is an alpha atom, therefore it will give the beta hydroxy compound. This is beta hydroxy compound, which will further undergo this is beta hydroxy compound. This reaction takes place in place of NOH. Now the acidic hydrogen atom here, H goes there, okay, this time, this time. Okay, so this is called as argon condition. Yes. Next question. PETN can be prepared by using acetaldehyde and HCHO followed by a reaction with reagent X. Identify the type of reactions involved and the reagent X. Can you guess what type of prepared it is? Acetaldehyde, CH3CHO. One more word was required here. CH3CHO followed by reaction with reagent reduction. PETN can be prepared by using acetaldehyde and formaldehyde in presence of alkali anhydrous baked anthracnone. Alkali halide. Other side, you must know what is PETN. PETN, I'll explain it later, let us see the reaction. Now, CH3CHO. Reacts with formaldehyde. Reaction takes place in terms of concentrated NOH, but the heart will take the reaction to the particular, but the retention will occur. It is treated with concentrated source of sedimentation. What type of reaction is? Can I guess? No guessing. Look here, this is not having any alpha hydrogen because alpha carbon itself is not there. And this has got, of course, sulfide atoms. Now this will undergo cross. Can Kenny's Arnold's reaction. Cross Kenny's Arnold's reaction. What happens is CHOH has to be done and you get CH2OH here. And that is known as Kenny's Arnold's reaction. So in the first step, you will get CH2OH alcohol. There is one more alpha hydrogen, another bit hydrogen. So, bit hydrogen. So, these bit hydrogen further it will react with one more LCH. So, this H is also converted to CH2H. Now, what reaction? Can be a Arnold reaction. Okay? Now there is one more hydrogen atom here, bit hydrogen. Therefore, this will react with one more formaldehyde. So this H is also converted to alcohol, CH2OH, 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 and we are making CHO. So all these three reactions are, what type of reaction it is? Arnold condensation. These are called as Arnold condensation. What is the meaning of Arnold condensation? Alpha hydrogen atoms are involved here. Okay? You are getting a hydroxy compound. So this is Arnold condensation, this also Arnold condensation, this also Arnold condensation. How many Arnold condensation taken place? Three Arnold condensation. Then this compound will further react CH2OH, CCH2OH, CH2OH, yeah, CH2. This will react with another molecule of formaldehyde. This also not having the alpha hydrogen atom. This also not having the alpha hydrogen atom. So, can what type of reaction tell them at all? Kenny's Arnold reaction. It will undergo Kenny's Arnold reaction. This also not having the alpha hydrogen atom. The function of CH2. The function of CH2. Both of them are not having the alpha hydrogen atom. And when they are treated with alkali, what type of reaction undergoes? Kenny's Arnold reaction. So there are three Arnold condensation reaction and one Kenny's Arnold reaction. What happens here? Kenny's Arnold reaction means CHOH converted to CH2OH and this converted to LCOOH. You know the Kenny's Arnold reaction. Self oxidation reaction, reduction reaction. So you are getting CH2OH, CCH2OH, CH2OH. This will also convert it to CHO, converts it to alcohol, and formaldehyde converts it to formic acid. Since sodium hydroxide is used in the reaction, you are getting the sodium salt of formic acid. Okay? This compound is called as pentaerythritol. This is pentaerythritol. It has got common OH groups, four hydroxyl groups. Okay? Now this is converted into subjected for nitration with mostly nitric acid. What happens? When it reaches nitric acid, all these OH groups are converted into nitro group. Okay? So what we are getting there? See, CH2NO2, 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 CH2NO2. PETL means pentaerythritol tetra nitrile. Peptan hydropentaric stop. This short is called as PETN. What is PETN? Tetranitro. Tetra means 4. 4 nitro, PETN. Tetranitro, penta, erythritol. And this is used for explosive. It is very highly explosive. PETN is highly explosive. That is NO2 group which makes it explosive. So, this is how the PETN is obtained. So, PETN can be prepared by using acetaldehyde and HCHO, followed by reaction with reagent X, identify the type of reaction involved reaction. Therefore, here you know that 3 aldehyde, formaldehyde, undergone reaction with CH2OH by Arnold condensation. This is 1 Arnold condensation, 2nd Arnold condensation, 3rd Arnold condensation. And you are getting this compound, that is the aldehyde which is not having the alpha hydrogen. And this compound will further undergo reaction with NMH to undergo what reaction take place? Kennedy-Zaros reaction. Therefore, in the preparation of pentaerythritol, there are 3 Arnold condensation reaction and 1 Kennedy-Zaros reaction to get pentaerythritol. And this pentaerythritol further undergo nitration. So, X is nitric acid. X is nitric acid. So, 3 Arnold condensation and 1 Kennedy-Zaros reaction, and the reagent is X is nitric acid. Okay, hope you have followed it. So, this is called as PETN. So, we have studied some typical reactions. Hope we will do it tomorrow. If time permits, we will do it tomorrow and solve the many questions. Thank you.